In this lesson, we'll create an identity policy and create a rule for passive authentication under identity policy. We will then apply our rules under the access control policy to our rules by selecting our users. Now let's come under the policy tab here. Let's come to identity here. Let's click new policy. Let our policy be called identity policy. Let's create a new rule by saying add rule here. Let our name be passive authentication. From here we select passive authentication. We're adding our inside zone to the source. We're also adding outside to destination. Let's choose which network we are going to do passive authentication for here. I choose 172.16.11.0 and add it to the source. Here I come to the realm part. Here I select Active Directory and say add. We will now perform passive authentication on users in the 172.16.11.0 subnet. We will also be able to select the users we want under the access control policy. Let's save the changes we made. Under the policy tab, let's come to access control policy. Let's edit a standby access control policy. Here we first need to select the identity policy that we created. Let's choose this first. I say OK. I save our settings. Now we can create user-based rules by selecting users under the rules we created earlier. Under this rule that we have already created, let's ensure that whichever users we want to allow access to the internet. Let's add it from here. I come to the user section. I select Activated Directory users. Here I select the IT group and add it here. I will allow users in the IT group and block users other than that. There are IT users and Yavuz Bulut users in the IT group. I save. Let's save our settings and then deploy and send the changes we made to the firewall. Our deployment process has been completed successfully. Now let's go to our user and do our testing. When we come to the user side, let's log in with the Yavuz Bulut user in the IT group. Let's open our web browser. Let's go into a few sites. Let's open another site. Let's create some traffic and then let's look at the logs. Now let's go to the FMC side and check our logs. Let's get to the analysis tab. Let's click on event from here. Let's come to the table part. When we come to the table section, you can now see the linked username in the log section. Let's get here. When you look at the user section here, you can see the information about the user. Now let's look at the eyes side. When we come to the eyes side, let's come to the menu. In the Work Center, let's click on Overview under Passive ID. Here you can see the users who are active in the live session. Now let's go to our client and check the IT user. Let's change our user here. I am connecting with it user. The IT user will also be able to access the internet because he is in the IT group. Let's open our web browser and try to access a page. Let's generate some traffic. Now let's look at the eyes side first, then we look at the firewall side. On the eyes side, you can see IT user here. Now let's look at the FMC side. Let's come to the event bottom. Let's click on the table. Here you can see that IT user's traffic is allowed. Now I came back to our user. Let's log in with IC user without permission. I open the web browser. When we try to access the internet, the firewall blocks us because we do not have permission. Let's open another page. As you can see, we don't have access. Now let's look at our logs. Let's refresh our table from here. From here you can see that the traffic is blocked. From the table tab here, you can see that the IC user has been denied access. Here you can see the block in the action section. Let's look at the eyes side. Let's make this place a refresh. Here you can see that active users are IC users and administrators. Let's say you have 100 active users, you can see all of them here. You can now create user-based rules under the access control policy in the firewall. That's how we do passive authentication. So goodbye to see you in our next lesson.